But coming back to my point, my central point, which is the hadith which I was saying, where Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is taking the guarantee. If your local mayor, your local councillor has said to you, I'll take zimmedari responsibility. If you come to a meeting once a day, just for an hour, I'll make sure I'll get you a good job. So you would go with full yaqeen that the mayor told me himself. The local councillor told me himself. Bruv, don't you know he's part of the Conservatives? Don't you know he's part of Labour? Don't you know he's part of Greenpeace? Don't you know he's part of this thing? Full yaqeen. Okay, but he's told me, so what guarantee do you want now? This is not just some makhluk of Allah who's in Morden or Wimbledon or South London. We're talking about the Allah who's in control of the whole universe. He's giving us this guarantee. If you just take out a little bit of time for me, I'll fill your heart with content and I will close your door of poverty. Poverty is something that will never ever, you'll never think you've got enough. The Prophet ﷺ mentioned this in the hadith. He mentioned, لَوْ كَانَ لِإِبْنِ آدَمْ وَادِيًا مِنْ ذَهَبْ أَحَبَّ أَنْ يَكُنُ لَهُ وَادِيًا. If you ever give the son of Adam a full value of gold, do you know what he'll turn around and say? I want another one. And he mentions another hadith, when he has two, he'll do what? لَبْدَغَى ثَالِثَ. You get, he'll have one, and then have another one, and then he'll say, now number three is coming. I want a third one now. Nothing will fill the stomach of this son of Adam except for the dust in the qabr and his grave. Khalas. Nothing else will fill his desires. So for you to think, no, once I have one house, inshallah, I'll feel content. Once you get there, then you look other people. Yaar, Bhat Sahab will call panche makan. He's got 5-6 houses. What have I got? Okay, now let me get two. Let me get two shops. Let me get one business. Let me get one in Sri Lanka, one here. One in Pakistan, one here. Oh, now international business. Oh, I need to get my children married. And marriage can't just be ijab and qabool. It's got to be 4-5 days full of mendiya and all these extra khurafat and then jaki shadi. And then all the jahaz on top of that. And finally, when we're finally dying, we say, let me go to Hajj and make ruju to Allah now. We neglected the children all that time, and then we're complaining the children are on the wrong path. This is what's happening, that's happening. Who was the responsible person for this? Allah said the solution easy, turn to me, I'll give. We didn't turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this maraz is everywhere across the globe. Our yaqeen has shifted away from the deen and come on to the things of Allah or Allah's creation. Our yaqeen has shifted away from Allah and it has come on to the makhluk of Allah. Our yaqeen has shifted away from Allah and come on to the ghayr of Allah. And we think that the solution to the Muslim problem is a very difficult one. Wallah, it's easy. When Allah mentioned deen is easy, what he means is to practice deen is very simple. It's not very complicated. Young children can figure it out. Quran and Hadith are there to serve as a guide for us. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you look, if having just accumulating masses of materialistic gains, if this was the sole sign for you to be successful, by the qasam of Allah, he wouldn't be such where he would have to be tying stones to his stomach because of the excess of hunger in his home. Point of mentioning is this. If you look into the life of the Prophet ﷺ, he lived a very, very restricted life in terms of what we would call worldly life. But that didn't make him a failure. That didn't mean he was a failure. We've just got to try and understand that a person's value isn't based on wealth. That's all I'm saying. I'm not trying to upset the status quo. I'm not trying to discourage sending your children to get an education. I'm not discouraging business as well. I'm not discouraging anything. I'm saying the solution to our problems is to take a little bit of time out also for our deen as well. When we look globally at the halat and conditions that are created, we've shifted our object from what we were sent. And that's why halat and conditions come. We complain of Syria, we complain of Ghouta, we complain of Palestine. Look at the root on what is being caused and why is it being caused. And as an ummah, we are all equally responsible for the actions in this ummah. When we do something, it has an implication. That's why Allah Ta'ala has chosen the ummah. When we do something, and if you want to know where we get this evidence from, ظَهَرَ الْفَسَادُ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ بِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِ النَّاسِ. Whatever you do, you perpetrate with your own hands, this... any fitna and fasad which appears throughout the earth will be the doing because of your own actions.